Hello and welcome to this series where I show and explain how a violin is built. Today's video is brought to you by my Patreons, which I thank very much for supporting my channel, and if you also appreciate my content and would like to support me, don't hesitate to visit my Patreon page, the link is in the description. Today's sponsor is also Akura Meister, who was so kind to send me the fittings to put on this instrument, because today's video is the last one of this series. Today I'm going to do the finishing work, glue the fingerboard, color the F-holes and the pegbox, and put the fittings and bridge and strings, and we are going to hear a couple of notes of this instrument. There are a lot of things that I have to do, so I will start immediately, and the first thing that I will do is glue the fingerboard again back on its place. But first I have to remove the protective piece of wood and all the tape of the neck. There is a little bit of varnish that I'm going to clean up with a very fine file. Now I can go ahead and glue the fingerboard on place. I will not glue the nut, only the fingerboard. I'm going to use hot glue and two clamps, as I don't need a lot of pressure because the fitting is perfect. This can stay like that for a couple of hours until the glue is dry.
The glue is dry, so I will remove the clamps.
I hadn't finished the fingerboard when I made it, because I knew I had to glue it once again. Now it is on its definitive position, and I can finish the surface of the fingerboard. As I'm working on the fingerboard, I'm going also to work on the neck. I want to remove a little bit of the varnish on both sides and make it a bit more round. I'm going to use a scraper to remove the varnish that I don't want. As soon as the fingerboard was ready, I also glued the nut on its place and finished it. Now that the fingerboard, nut and neck are finished, I'm going to put a little bit of stain on the neck to become a bit darker, as it is very, very white. That will dry very fast, and then I will put a bit of linseed oil so I can keep the instrument from the neck while I'm working, making the pegs and so on, without making this dirty again or ruining it. This golden brown stain will do perfectly the job. I have used it also on other instruments and I was very satisfied with the result. The neck and fingerboard are finished. That means that I can go ahead and mount the pegs on the violin. And as I said at the beginning, I'm going to use this Ebony Ultimo set from Akura Meister. As we have seen in the past how I make the pegs, I'm going to do it a little bit faster. If you still want to know how I did, you can find the video here.
legs. Check. Now I'm going ahead. I'm going to clean the F holes because there are some droplets of varnish that have gone inside. And I'm going to paint them and the peg box black. To paint the F holes and peg box, I am using an acrylic matte black paint. Fortunately, the black paint that I used dries very quickly. I have to wait maybe 10 minutes. So in the meantime, I'm going to place the end button on its place. And this is a very special end button as it comes apart and gives you the possibility to check the soundpost through the hole without having to remove the strings, tailpiece and end button. And now it's time to put the soundpost in place. I will start by measuring the height. And now I'm going to use this tool to cut the two ends of the soundpost, and this tool helps me to cut in the correct angle. And there we go into the violin. And so we arrive at the last part that I have to make on my own, which is the bridge. And I'm going to use a bridge that I bought in 2005 when I was still studying in Cremona. And it is a Despieux with three small trees on it. I will start by marking and cutting the feet of the bridge. Every now and then I can control if it is already a tight fitting. As soon as the feet are ready, I mark the height of the fingerboard onto the bridge and then the height of the bridge. I always make my bridges a little bit too high so I can finish them according to the wishes of the player. And now I will remove this extra wood with a knife. And finish it with a file. Next, I will mark the thickness for the upper part. I will use this tool to keep the bridge on its place while I am working with a plane and files. If you also want to make a tool like this, don't forget to have a look to the video I made. The link will be here. Now I'm going to do some trimmings, like removing a part here, work on this part, and finally break the corners. The instrument is finished. I have to mount it. I will use the tailpiece by Akkurameister. And I was thinking about mounting these Pirastro Eva Pirazzi gold strings. I haven't used them in the past and I'm looking forward to hear them. As you see, and as you just listened, the violin is finished, it's ready, it's playing, and we don't have to do anything anymore than play on it. That means that this is also the end of the Making a Violin series. 23 episodes. Thank you very much for watching all the 23 times. Also, many thanks once again to the Patreons for supporting the channel, to Akkurameister for sending me the pegs. As the series was finishing, I was thinking, what am I going to do after this? I thought making a new violin wouldn't be so interesting for you, as you have already seen this. So I decided to make some other kind of instrument. It is still a boat instrument, as I only make boat instruments, but not a violin, viola or cello. And it is a surprise. I'm not going to tell you today what it's going to be, because, and here comes the second thing that I wanted to talk to you about, the other sponsor. As you all may know, this series started with the review and unboxing of the mold that I used for this violin, which was the mold made by Grandi Liutai, this one. And as I was reaching the end of the series, I spoke with the owner of the company and I asked if he would like to sponsor today's video with a gift for you, and he accepted and he sent me some molds for you, but because of all the situation on the world, everything goes a bit slower. They have not reached me yet, but I know that they are coming. There will be more than one, and that will be the giveaway of today's video. But I'm not going to make it very easy for you. Leave a comment below and let me know what you think that the instrument will be that I'm going to make in the next series. If anyone finds it out, he will receive a mold. And if no one knows which instrument it will be, I will choose one randomly. And I'm going to give away at least two molds at once, so two presents. And one will go only to the Patreons, so go to my Patreon page if you are a Patreon and leave a comment under the post with the mold so you can participate. And one will go to all the rest of the viewers. So that's it for today's video. Please stick around as there is a small part that I want you to see just after the outro. Thank you very much for watching once again. Many thanks to the Patreons for supporting the channel and the two sponsors. And I will see you again in October with a new series. Bye bye!